key, which seemed to be meant for a padlock, bore an inscription reading Clutze et Fils. A company name. Better keep an eye open. Businesses weren't exactly numerous around these parts. The Spirograph amused Carl. It was a nice modern toy, aside from being repetitive by nature and completely useless. Still, it found its way into many Quebecois homes. Window left open in that weather? Perhaps something had to be watched. The sheets were in such a way that indicated a rude awakening, followed by a hurried escape. What had happened here? Carl's big fingers prevented him from reaching the key. Little Martin Blais with his uncle Pierre. There was a deep sense of bonding and pride coming out of the picture. Carl felt sorry for the man. No one deserved such a cruel fate. The picture had been taken inside the house. It was the same wallpaper. Judging by the smiles, nobody suspected the impending misfortunes. The track was fresh. That meant the car sunk down just a little while ago. Now where the hell could the passengers possibly have gone? Someone had been playing with a crossbow here. A very dangerous game. A bolt could hit someone's tire, or their eye. It could even kill someone if the aim was right. Thank you. Someone must have dropped this in a hurry, but whoever did was heading into the woods. Carl's tracking instincts were quickly kicking in. Was only void where the road should be. Carl hated dead ends. He felt trapped. It was as if the road had... drowned in the lake. He would have to find help by another road. Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold. It was a typical shack, just like the ones you hear about in Quebecois legends. Local lumberjacks used it to rest and, twice a day, heat up their pea soup. The leftover food, the clothes, the general warmth of the place, no evidence of escape. Carl was sure of it. People were here not long ago, and they expected to come back. Who quits a game one step away from victory? Welcome to Alibaba's Cave, Lumberjack Edition. Surely Carl would find something worth his time in here. The crossbow bolts had the same origin. Carl was sure of it. Who was it? And more importantly, what was being hunted like this? Without a single window to brighten things up, the inside of the cabin was almost pitch black. Beware of close encounters of knee and furniture. Solitaire, a card game only hermits can truly enjoy. Carl felt depressed at the thought of playing this. Everything was set up for a well-deserved snack. It seemed like the place hadn't been empty for long, but without knowing exactly why, Carl had the feeling no one was coming back anytime soon. Carl was becoming increasingly convinced that this was not normal hunting. The game that was being tracked was fearsome, so much so that the hunter didn't dare approach it. What could it be? The air was freezing, right down to the bone. The otherworldly ice had struck again. The woman's hopes and dreams were frozen in eternity. Something was hidden under the stairs. The man grabbed his rifle. Carl felt a sense of dread in him. Perhaps their spousal relationship had been cooling down lately. It seemed like secrecy was commonplace in this house. The vision's veil was lifted, and he was back to reality. A reality in which Giselle, Jill's loving spouse, was motionless, frozen in ice. The pot was cold, and the stew inside wasn't cooked. It's likely that poor Giselle was slow cooking it before she got snapped. What a waste. That window had seemingly been left open for a while, Carl thought. Given the punishing weather, it couldn't have been intentional. Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold. Looks like the holes in that puzzle are there to stay. Moving. What a pleasant activity. Of course, you'll find the record player only to find the records weeks later in some random box. The general store, along with several more infrastructures in the area, had been acquired by wealthy industrialist William J. Hamilton. Perhaps the village should be rechristened Hamiltown. Carl had seen that kind of safe before, with its double-layered security system blending letters and numbers. Its code couldn't be broken by the common burglar. Many boxes scattered about. Carl didn't need to summon his detective training to quickly figure that the Lachauses had just moved in. It felt like old people were all these walls could see for years. The Lachauses could hardly be blamed for wanting to freshen things up a bit. What a mess! Clearly, there was some major revamping work underway here. The place looked barely habitable. Many boxes scattered about. Carl didn't need to summon his detective training to quickly figure that the Lachauses had just moved in. A nice white coating would restore the room to its charm of olden days. Beautiful portrait of Gilles and Giselle, bound together by the chains of conventional love. The cross looked after a marriage's well-being and served as a motivator to uphold the priest's sermons calling for more little worshippers on one hand and cautioning against guilty pleasures on the other. Indeed, the Lachauses were still part of the God-fearing generation. A nice white coating would restore the room to its charm of olden days. Many boxes scattered about. Carl didn't need to summon his detective training to quickly figure that the Lachauses had just moved in.